Hi, I'm Neil, and I'm here to show you some skiing equipment ranging from very old to very new. Our first pair of skis are a 10-foot long solid piece of hickory ski with just a very simple leather binding to hold the toe piece of the boot in. They're beautifully carved and they're a real work of art. They're about 100 years old. This pair of skis is about 10 feet long. It's made of solid wood core with a wooden top sheet and a wooden base screwed on edges. It has a throw with a spring and a very primitive metal toe piece. Well, it has leather straps to hold the boots in place, and also a cable that goes around the heel piece. These skis were used for jumping and skiing in the 1930s. This is a wooden Nordic ski, but it has the traditional 3-pin Nordic binding that was also originally used for the revival of telemark skiing. We'll take our old leather boot with the 3-pin duckbill binding. It fits right in there. And then the front throw goes down and it locks the boot into the binding, securing the boot to the ski. The ski has an all wooden base, and actually pine tar was used as a kind of grip wax to accelerate forward movement in the snow. These boots date back to about 1948. They were from the Sears and Roebuck catalog. All leather boot. Imagine how long it took to lace these up. The soles were replaced about 30 years ago with the traditional duckbill for telemark skiing. Again, low-cut boot, all leather, genuine Sears and Roebuck. This is a pair of children's skis from about 1960. It's an all-wood ski with a screwed-on metal edge, a screwed-on metal tip protector, as well as the traditional front throw metal binding, primitive toe plate, and very primitive heel throw. These skis got some use here in Colorado. These telemark boots date from about 1990. You can see how the leather boot has increased in height, as well as a double boot with a plastic stiffener and plastic ratcheted buckles to give more control. Notice there's not too much difference between the old Alpine boots and the newer telemark boots, but still with the duckbill and the 3 pins. In about the mid-1990s, Black Diamond and Scarpa teamed up to create the first plastic telemark boots. Not dissimilar to regular Alpine skiing boots, they still have the duckbill toe, but they have the bellows flex built into the foot. As well as, we're now on a traditional ski with the P-Tex base, wood or foam core, and a plastic laminate on the top, full-length metal edges. The bindings feature a real sturdy steel toe box, a full wraparound cable with the heel throw, as well as climbing posts that aid when the skier is climbing uphill with climbing skins on. Latest development in telemark gear has been the new telemark North. The duckbill toe piece is eliminated. We still have the full plastic boot with the bellows in the toe, but it's a full metal binding with a step-in and a ski brake instead of a safety leash that still offers full flexion for skiing downhill as well as skiing up the hill with climbing skins on. Heel posts for climbing as well. This is a high-performance telemark setup.
And now on the edges with my